Hello explorers and welcome to another video. Today I'm going to talk a little bit about cloud training. So we have in the previous episode talk about how to prepare your data, how to configure your training, how to run your training locally, and today we're going to talk about running it in the cloud. And why should you run your training in the cloud? Well, maybe you have a computer at home or at work that isn't really made for running these kind of tasks, or perhaps you are in a time-sensitive window, so you need something done a little bit quicker than you can do locally. Because in the cloud, you can put as much compute power to the problem as you like, but on your local machine, you are restricted to the actual power that you have locally. So first off, before you can actually run something in the cloud, you need to actually package your object detection library offline. So if we look at this command here, we will actually build the PyTools. So we have those built, and then we run the Python setup sdist, which will actually create a package that we can deploy online to the cloud and run this object detection library online. And we also need to package the slim package because it's also required by this object detection library, so we will build that as well. With this command, we go into the slim package, we run the setup there and run sdist on that as well, and that will package it down and create a tar gsep bundle that we can upload to the cloud server. Next up, we need to set up a server in the cloud. So we create a project online. We initialize that project either by downloading the gcloud SDK, which we are required to have, and installing that, and that will prompt you to actually initialize it and set it up with your online project. Or if you already have it installed and want to change project, you can run gcloud in it and actually initialize it again offline, and you do that from that directory you want to run your instance from, in this case the TensorFlow models research. Another thing that we actually need is we need to set up a bucket where we can place both our data and the configuration that we talked about in two episodes previously. I will link that episode as well, so you can see how you set up a configuration for object detection. And we go to the cloud here, we can create a bucket, we will get that bucket, we will put our training data, so the images that we want to train on, and also the label file, and then we want to add the configuration file, but we want to make a few small changes, because the configuration file needs to have these kind of paths, so it finds it in the gcloud storage under a subfolder somewhere. So this is my bucket name, and then I have a subfolder in there where I have both my label file and my training records. So this configuration needs to be changed to have these kind of paths in it, and you also need to actually point out where this configuration is, but we come to that. So when we have set that up, we can run our compute engine job by running gcloud ML engine. So this is the machine learning engine. We want to create a job. We want to submit this new job. It's a training job, and we want to give it a name. So we give it object detection with a date. So this is just to get some nice naming so you can easily find it, and you can see when you actually started this job. And I ran about 5 jobs, so it was quite nice to see that, okay, here's my new job, it started now, so I know which was the latest job. And then I say which runtime version I want to run on. Here I put 1.7. I think the last one is 1.8. So you put it in here, what kind of runtime version you want. You can put that in your configuration file as well. Then I say where the job dir is. So this is where it actually works and where it will save the model or the checkpoints when it's training. I also need some distribution packages. So I will need to run with this command, so I actually upload my current built object detection library and also the current slim package in my local build directory. So those I need to also send to the cloud, and I want to say which model name I want to run. In this case it's object detection dot train. We give it a region we want to run it in. I run it in on the US Central 1 region. Depending on what you need for your job, you might want to run it in the EU, or you might want to look into other region. I run it at the US Central because in the US they had later versions of the runtime, so I can actually run TensorFlow 1.8 and not an earlier version. And this is my configuration, this is my local configuration. So on my local computer, where is my configuration file? And then I need to say where my training there is, and this is on the G storage cloud. So this is where it will, the first job dir is where it will save all the job related files. So this is log files and so on, and the training dir is actually where it will save the checkpoint data. But I put it in the same directory, I didn't want to have a large structure of different directories, it's not that important. You will find your training data there as well, and it could be good to have them contained so you can zip everything and download it later. And then I want this path to my pipeline configuration path, and that's our model path. So this is the configuration that we talked about earlier. So let's look at this training file, what we can actually define in the training file to set up our cluster. And in my case, I wanted to run it on a custom tier. You can run it on a basic tier, that's just a computer with no GPU. Then you can run it on a basic GPU, so you get Tesla K80 GPU. You can run it on a basic TPU, then you get one computer with the TensorFlow processing unit. Or you can run it in custom. And when you run it in custom, you get a few more parameters that you can set up. First off is the master type. This is the master that will actually sync and keep everything else running and actually make your little network of workers set it up and tear it down. So this is just a standard GPU machine. You can run this in a lot of different setups. A standard GPU is this Tesla K80 again. And this will probably change depending on when you run this, because the hardware will be updated. So you will look into the documentation and see what you actually get for it, if you are interested. Or you just say, I want a standard GPU, and that's fine. You can have a premium GPU. You can go all the way up to say that I want a cloud TPU, and then you will get the best processing power for the money. And then you say what you want your worker type to be. So this is your worker servers, and you can set how many of the worker servers you want to run. I ran 9 worker servers. And then you need some parameter servers, and this will sync your servers with the actual biases and weights. So it's good to have a few of those. I ran 3 of those because I have 9 workers, so a third was my count there. And this is actually a setup that they are suggesting on the wiki pages or the repository of the TensorFlow research. So I just copy these parameters. You can supply the runtime version again. You can also supply a Python version. I set it to 2.7, and if you put it to 3.6, which could be a good thing, you need to actually do the fix where you go in and change it to use list instead of just simple range. We talked about that in the local training. The same applies here if you run 3.6. I put it to 2.7 at the moment, but it's not that important which version you run. I think 2.7 is supported 2 more years, so it should be fine for now, if you can run it. So I ran this setup of with the training input for, I think I ran it 5 or 6 times to actually test it out. And I actually ran out of memory for my model, so it crashed a number of times. And during this, I think if I just surmise how much it actually trained, it trained a fifth of the actual training data. So I had to run it at least 5 times as long, and that cost me $20. So I guess a standard model with images and 200,000 iterations will cost me $100. And I have a pretty good computer at home, it wasn't that much faster for me to run it on standard GPUs in online. I think it was double the speed of offline, so I wasn't really that keen on burning money on this case, and especially as it actually threw a memory out of memory exception and just crashed. So I think you have to set up this and actually try out different configuration until you actually find something that works for you. And perhaps you should start with a basic GPU, so you just run one computer until you have actually tried your model out, and then run it with a little bit more compute power if you want to try this out yourself. I hope that you found this video interesting. I hope that you learned something today. If you have any questions about training your models online and so on, then please send them my way in the comment section below. If you like this video, give it a like, share it with your friends and colleagues. And if you haven't subscribed yet, please do that. And I really hope to see you in the next video.